My pleasure to welcome Hiten Ghosh. He is the Vice President and Chief Quality Officer with Hughes Network and also the past Vice President for Pan IIT USA. Hiten, it's a pleasure to welcome you.
Thank you.
A lot of work has gone into building Pan IIT USA. You are one of the early members of this, has done tremendous work to bring where it is, and you continue to work to take this forward. So before I ask you, you know, where we should, for the roadmap going forward, let me take you back to the time when you were actually in a delegation working on the IP situation with the Indian government. Mm-hmm. So share some of that experience with us.
Okay. Let me put a bright perspective of IP delegation. I have been at this alumni movement from 1998. We started a small chapter, which is truly the Pan IIT. It's almost second, because you have enough people in individual alumni associations. We formed it together. I'm one of the co-founders. From that, when you said, first thing, what should we do? As a, would it be only drinking or social, or we should have something purpose? They said, India, as it goes, must have research. And to do research, we need a lot of resources from outside. And if you do the outside, first thing they will say, is my intellectual property protected? So with that, we had the first conference, which is Pan IIT Nature, in 2002 in October, done, hosted by our chapter. This is before the 2003 US big conference. In that conference, our whole thing was giving back, and IP was the only topic. So from that, we came to a thing that we ought to take now, a delegation to India more for training, awareness, and facing the way. So we got hold of the chief of the patent office here, Judge Roder, professors from George Washington University, and Raj Dave was really the sponsor. I was with him. I basically helped him with on the Capital IIT and Pan IIT. And we sponsored the delegation, and you will be believe what kind of reception we got in India. We had meeting, was sponsored by CII, Confederation of Indian Industry, FICCI. They all sponsored it. Delhi, Madras, Mumbai, Cochin, Bangalore. We went all the places, and there we had moot court. Judge Roder, of course, is the top. And the chief judge of the Bombay High Court, justices of the Supreme Court came, actually took the class. Because they, of course, protocol-wise, they responded to Judge Roder. And out of that thing, then we took the delegation to West Bengal. Because at that time, Communist Party was very strong. And government was worried about, there's a bill in the parliament which may not pass, the patent bill. So I remember Buddhadev Bhattacharya told me, what do you think we are here for? So Judge Roder stepped in. He says, Mr. Chief Minister, I came to know that you have the first patent office of India in your Calcutta. And you are probably the only country where national patent office is not in your national capital. Do you know the potential? He said, what is that? Then he described the intellectual property, technology transfer, how he has worked to create Munich, the center of Europe in the IP. Next day, we got a call from him. He said, give me a business plan. And that has gone in to modify the patent office. Since then, every year, Raj Dave has taken delegation to USA. So if you have anybody to give credit, Dr. Raj Dave. He was, by the way, one of the co-founders of Pan IIT, of Capital Chapter.
Moving forward, let's talk about your role, as the vice chairman.
Okay.
And then we talk about where we are.
Well, since then I went, became the vice president under a very good individual. His name is Abhay Bhushan. He was the first graduate of IIT Kanpur. He was almost like a mentor in this Pan IIT. I was vice president for 2 years under him. Then myself and Suresh Chinoy became co-chair, co-president of Pan IIT USA, 2005-2006. And we did a lot of work. We really helped create the Pan IIT India organization. And we went abroad. And we have now six or seven national, Canada, Singapore, Australia, UK, and Japan. This is all done, so we became a Pan-IIT Global, and we have got organization all set up. So as we go forward, then we say, we have done the first step. In fact, it was recognized in 2005, which me and Suresh co-sponsored it and managed it. HR 227 in US Congress passed a resolution recognizing IITs as contributing the prosperity, health, and success of the United States. It is probably the only institution has been honored in US Congress. So then you think forward, fast forward is, we individually were successful, recognized by the best of the USA. What are we going to do the next? So then we came with the concept of collective contribution rather than individual contribution. Why? Because we find that through the collaboration networking with not only Pan-IIT India, which by the way has gone fantastic ahead in many of the nation building projects, that we can now start getting India and USA, these two Pan-IIT organizations together along with the other countries, and do some of this thing which is very important, which is really the mission of Pan-IIT. Because if you look at the IIT was created by the government and the taxpayers. Who are they? 70% of them still in the villages, okay? They have not gone through the appropriate education, etc. Even though there are significant improvement, but from that point on, if we have succeeded through their help, because our education was dirt cheap, because of they are the people who pay taxes, then we have something to give back. So what we are now doing, as an alumni organization, working with the IIT director, that while we're going towards the research, development, and making each of the IIT a center of competency in their choice, best in the world, we must also do reaching out education for the 70% of the people who are in need. They cannot even go through the JE unless you help them. So you saw the program that we did and the contribution. So individual IIT did that, and now we are saying, why not encompass that? Make it a Pan-IIT foundation to help them prepare for the JE exam so they can succeed. Okay, those are the things, is a new thing. And to basically summarize it, working with the Pan-IIT India and us, we are creating a program called I Will Impact. Okay, this is started in India in 2006 by Asan Desai, Pradeep Gupta as leadership. 7 nation building project, and they all succeeded. There's a video, etc. we showed. Now we are combining that, and you can see in the end, this is now USA and India. And this is a very important concept. We have not only want to work for India, but we also adopted USA as our adopted home. What we are doing to contribute to USA. Today there's so much problem of USA. Okay, what can we help? So now this is getting a tremendous traction in any of the US government, industry that we talk about, that hey, these people are good. They are not only talking about India, they also want to help USA. So that's called bilateral. That's a program called WHIL. So WHIL and Indian organization together is a bilateral effort, whereas some of the solutions that we have here cannot be applied directly in India. We'll help to transform. So to summarize it, new motion is IIT means not just Indian Institute of Technology, is inspire, involve, and transform. That's the new roadmap.
Etienda, on that note, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.